Welcome to Dental and Ayurveda, a channel for basic dental and Ayurvedic sciences. Our today's chapter is Impression Material, a chapter of Dental Materials BDS, and our today's topic is Modified Glass Ionomer Cement.
Hello everyone. So in this video, we are going to discuss about Modified Glass Ionomer Cements. So these are of two types. One is metal modified GIC and the second is resin modified GIC. So metal modified glass ionomer cements, these are introduced to improve the strength, fracture toughness and resistance to wear, and yet they maintain the potential for adhesion and anti-karyogenic properties. So these are two types, like two methods we use. That is, first is silver alloy admixed and the second is sorbent. In cement, silver particles are bonded to glass particles, and this is done by sintering a mixture of the two powders at a high temperature. Then we talk about the uses. So about the uses, first it is used for restoration of small class 1 cavities as an alternative to amalgam or composites. Then it is particularly it is useful in young patients who are more prone to caries. Then you can see that for core buildup also we use it for the grossly destructed teeth. Then we talk about the properties. So first is the mechanical property. In mechanical properties, we discuss about strength, fracture toughness. So strength is not so much improved over that of the conventional cement. Then you can see that the fracture toughness of metal modified GIC is similar to that of conventional GIC. In the mouth, both metal modified and conventional GIC, they appear to have similar wear rates. So wear resistance is almost similar. So from the above properties, it is clear that there is no appreciable advantage. Matlab, iska koi advantage nahi hai modified GIC ka. So over conventional GIC. So the other clinical performance of cement cements is considered to be inferior to that of other restorative materials. Then if we discuss about anti-karyogenic property, so both the metal modified ionomers have anti-karyogenic capability due to leaching of fluoride. So less fluoride release hoga from cement than restorative GIC, since the glass particle is metal coated. Kyunki usme jo glass particles hain wo metal coated honge. Then you can see admixed cement, it is going to release more fluoride than restorative GIC. Here the metal filler particles are not bonded to the cement matrix and thus they are pathways for fluid exchange. So this is going to increase the leaching of fluoride. Then we talk about aesthetics. So these are gray in color because of metallic faces within them. And so they cannot be used for anterior teeth because as they are gray in color, so aesthetic ka problem hota hai, then we cannot use it for our anterior. Then we talk about resin modified glass ionomer. So these are relatively new materials. Okay, new material having various names. बहुत सारे नाम से हम इसे बोल सकते हैं. That is, first is compomer, second is resin ionomers, then RMGI, that is resin modified glass ionomer we call it, and then it can be light cure GIC, dual cure GIC. So all these are the names for this. Then these materials were developed to overcome some drawbacks of conventional GIC, like moisture sensitivity, low initial strength and fixed working times. So in materials ko hum ye sari problems se bachne ke liye bhi develop. Then something about classification. So resin modified glass ionomer cement. Then second, it is the compomers or polyacid modified composites. You can see the examples. Then we talk about the use of these resin modified. So uses is simple, that it is used for class 1, class 3 and class 5 cavity restorations. Then you can use it as bases and liners. Phir hum ise as adhesive bhi use kar sakte hain for orthodontic brackets. And then we can use it for cementation of crowns and FPDs. Then you have to use it for repair of the damaged amalgam cores or cusps. Then you can use for retrograde root filling. So it is supplied as amical cure It can be in the form of dual cure and tricure. So dual cure is like combining the acid-base setting reaction of the GIC portion and light curing of the resin portion. So this is about how it is. Then composition. So since these are combination materials, ye combination se bante hai, so they are going to contain components of both resin and glass ion. So in powder form, you can see ion leachable glasses present, photo initiators are there. Then you have polymerizable resin, then you have hydroxyethyl methacrylate monomers. In liquid, you have polyacrylic acid, water, and methacrylate monomer. And then you, for setting reaction, it includes both polymerization and acid-base reaction, dono honge. The initial setting occurs by polymerization of methacrylate groups, giving it a very high early strength. Then manipulation. So in this, you are going to mix, RMGI is mixed and applied after conditioning the tooth with polyacrylic acid. Then about properties. So properties, strength. So the compressive strength is slightly lower as compared to conventional GIC, and they're going to have a great fracture toughness. The hardness, you can see, it is comparable to conventional GIC. And adhesion, these materials bond better to composite resins than conventional GIC, kyunki isme unreacted monomers present hote hain RMGI, that's why. Then you have that these materials have a greater amount of micro leakage when compared to GIC. Then you can see about anti-karyogenicity. So these materials have a significant anti-karyogenic effect because of fluoride release. Then purple response hoga inka to the cement, which is very mild. And aesthetics, they are more translucent and therefore more aesthetic than conventional GIC. So conventional GIC se more zyada achhi aesthetic hoti hai inki.
Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe. And this chapter ke ready to read notes available hai hamare Instagram page pe, jiska link given hai description box mein.